Hey guys, welcome back. Do you know what? I was desperately craving a skate today. I really need it. Let's just call it self-care. I don't know if you're like me, but sometimes I just go through waves of anxiety or, you know, just feelings of depression. It's that time of the year where they call it the winter blues, you know? Sun affected disorder. Yeah, SAD. Ironically, what a name to call it, but yeah, that's the kind of feeling that we feel, right? We feel a little bit sad because we don't have as much vitamin D, and I mean the skies are kind of grey, but you know, we just have to push ourselves to feel good, and anything that makes you feel good, you really need to give that to yourself. So that's what I'm doing. So I've got a couple of hours before they say it's gonna rain at 5 o'clock, so I'm just gonna try and enjoy a couple of hours of skating. I really need to practice. There's a meetup that I've organized this weekend, and it's like a soul train skate, and hopefully I can get to share the footage with you at some point. And yeah, so I just wanna practice for it and just like lift up my spirits basically, and I hope that I can lift up yours as well if you're going through what I'm going through. Yeah, self-care is the best care. We really gotta look after ourselves, and sometimes you just have to just give yourself this time, you know, even if it's for half an hour, just give it to yourself, and then you can get back onto the tasks that you maybe haven't completed or that you have to complete. Do you know what I mean? Okay, let's get skating. Every time I go out and skate, I have to warm up, especially if I'm feeling anxious about anything. I just put on some chill out sounds and I just skate for a little bit before I go on a big old skate or before I start to jam skate. I'm sweating. I am sweating. I don't know if it's a mixture of the angle. Well, I know it is. Let me just say what it is. So I'm sweating because this coat is hella warm, I'm telling you. And as soon as you start skating, you feel warm, okay? It's about 13 degrees out here and I am hot. So also I think it's a mixture of my anxiety as well. Yeah, I just feel nervous, like unnecessary. It feels like an unnecessary reason to be nervous, like you feel like something bad's gonna happen. It's an awful feeling. Anyone who has anxiety, I know that you'll understand what I'm saying, but again, I'm just gonna put on my headphones and just zone out and practice. Yeah, so I'm just gonna record myself practicing, and I'll either put music over this or I won't. Anyway guys, let's get skating. I just want to shake off this feeling and just be free and express myself. Do you know what? I just need to drill a lot of things that I promised myself I would and I haven't. Yeah, so I better get on with it. Okay, first things first, I am taking off this coat. Come on, it's so hot. The barrel roll is a skill that I have been trying to master for a little while now. I've been practicing it like seriously for a couple of weeks, and I think I'm starting to get it. I probably need to go back to the person that showed me how to do this. I need to be around someone who knows how to do the barrel roll correctly, just so that I can kind of like pick it up again and just get more clarification that I'm doing it the right way. I think I am. I'm so frustrated with this move, but I will get it. Yes, yeah, sometimes I just jump around, stamp around, turn around and spin around just to stamp out my nerves, if that makes sense, because the anxiety is like really irritating at this point. Like, you know, I've got butterflies and I'm feeling nervous for no reason, and I just like stamp it out. And I think sometimes we're frightened of falling, and it could be that. So sometimes when I jump, it makes me feel better. And here I am backwards skating. This is something I really need to do better at. Like, it's a skill that I really need to take my time and improve on. And a lot of the time when I go out skating, I don't spend enough time backwards skating. And I promise myself that every time I skate, I'm gonna backwards skate for a good period of time, just to build up muscle memory, to build up confidence, and just to get there, just to get to the level I need to be at. I'm breathing now because my anxiety is like taking the piss, okay? It's trying to ruin my skate experience, and breathing really does help. If you're nervous or if you have any kind of anxious feeling or if you're feeling low, breathing in is so good for us. Tell you the honest truth, I never used to stretch until I started to roller skate. I knew that I had to stretch because I was skating for hours and hours during lockdown.
we would be out for maybe 5, 6, 7 hours a day because it was unlimited exercise, you know, and it was just such an amazing time. The roller skating renaissance 2020/2021 was absolutely phenomenal, and we were out most of the day, especially if you were on furlough. But stretching, I just think it's amazing. It's changed my life. At first it was difficult, and now I honestly depend on stretching daily. I recommend it, guys. If it hurts in the beginning, don't worry, it will get easier. A fun fact about the C-step, it's one of my favourite moves. There's so many different variations to it, but I'm petrified of it. Trust me, I've had so many injuries doing the C-step, but don't let that put you off. Just keep practicing, you'll get there. It's a fantastic jam move. The half turn is a move that I learned from a really cool jam skater called Joe, who skates at Hyde Park. And listen, it looks like the most simplest move, but for some reason I struggle with it. Some days I get it so perfect, but today I don't know what the heck I'm doing. It's going wrong, but I'll get there. I've been practicing this half turn since August 2021 and I still don't have it on point. It goes to show, right? Like, everyone has their own time of getting it. Like, sometimes you unlock it, and when you unlock it, it just takes time to understand it. I'll get there. I absolutely love spinning, and I really want to just be so, so excellent at it. Can you believe that I actually have severe motion sickness? But actually, I think spinning on skates has reduced it, because I do not like getting into cars, literally any vehicle, coaches, buses, planes, ships. I always feel extremely nauseous. And ever since I started learning how to spin on skates, I don't really have that problem anymore. Like, you would never catch me on a fairground ride, like a roller coaster or a swing. No, because it just would upset my stomach. But listen, spinning is something you have to practice every single time you go roller skating. Do not be frightened of it. It's all to do with your core, balance, center of gravity, all of that jazz. And it's such a freeing experience. Okay, so I'm doing the moonwalk. I've always wanted to be able to do the moonwalk like Michael Jackson. And I seem to only be able to do that on skates. And you know what? That's good enough for me. Sometimes I put on Billie Jean and I'm like, I feel so cool, man. Like, seriously, it's a really good skill to learn. Crazy legs is such a cool jam move. It's all to do with coordination. It is called crazy legs because it will drive you crazy trying to learn it, okay? But once you get the knack of it, there are so many different variations. And if you just want to jam skate and you don't know what to do, it's just kind of like the downtown. It's just a go-to move and it just looks so cool. Okay, this is where I thank my stretching, because I very, very rarely drill the side surf. I think this is probably actually the first day that I've genuinely tried to try it outside. Like, I've normally stretched into it just to see what my feet can do, but I've never gone for it. And I felt really proud of myself in this moment. And you know what, guys? I'm feeling so much better. I felt so good. And obviously, you know, exercise, when you exercise, your body releases chemicals called endorphins. And my endorphins are like glitter inside me right now. I'm just feeling so, so much better, so more relaxed, a lot more positive, you know? It's a nice feeling. It actually took a lot for me to get out of the house and to go roller skating today. I love roller skating, and my anxiety really held me back really try techniques that will help you to ease those feelings that you have when you feel scared to skate, when you feel doubtful, when you feel worried. Avoid caffeine, drink water, you know, do breathing exercises, do your stretching, just focus, put on some music, maybe take some headphones and listen to some chill out music, and drill. Drilling, like practicing, drilling, whatever you want to call it. I prefer the term practicing, to be honest. It really takes your mind to a different place and it makes you forget about your worries, and you will definitely start to feel better. It's just nature just takes over. And like I said, endorphins are released and you get this kind of happy buzz, especially if roller skating is your passion. If you've reached a plateau in your roller skating journey, that's okay. It's normal. It happens. But get back on track, guys. Put your skates on, go skating and have fun. Don't let anything stop you from your roller skating journey. Happy skating, guys.